The Minister of Basic Education and Jimutega, accompanied by Free State Education MEC Tate Mahwe, are expected to visit schools in the Mangaung area. The minister embarked on a series of visits to primary schools to monitor teaching and learning since they were allowed to receive learners at full capacity in terms of the risk-adjusted differentiated strategy. The strategy provides for schools to, where possible, receive all learners at primary school level as part of a gradual return to traditional timetabling. We bring you the latest on this story from our SABC News colleague, Aphumelele Mdlalane in Bloemfontein. A very good morning to you, Aphumelele. Is the minister there already?
Good morning to you, Desiree, and also to the viewers at home. We're still waiting for Minister Angie Motshekga to arrive at Butlehadi Primary School. This is one of the schools in Bloemfontein that she will be visiting to assess the state of readiness. As we know that it was announced that primary schools that are ready to take full capacity of learners, they should do so. And the Department of Education in the province has been doing quite well in terms of vaccinating teachers and other supporting staff, but I understand that here in the province they are expecting to have full capacity of learners from next week, Tuesday. I just want to bring the spokesperson for Education Department, Howard Ndaba. Thank you so much, sir, for your time. Are you ready as the province to receive a full capacity for learners?
Thank you very much. But firstly, let me take this opportunity to welcome the minister in the province. I can with confidence indicate that we are indeed ready to welcome all learners in our province, especially in our grade R to grade 7. But the biggest challenge now in the province, we have divided our schools into small school, medium schools, large school, and mega school. With your large and mega school, we might have a challenge. We have been engaging with our district to establish as to whether to indicate whether are we indeed ready to each school to indicate and give us an indication whether on Tuesday will they be able to welcome all learners owing to the size of the school. But we have also encouraged our school to find creative ways under this difficult condition to make sure that at the end of the day we save teaching time. The reality is, as a sector, we have lost a lot of teaching time since from last year with lockdown level 5. At the beginning of the year, we started very late our academic year. So we are under pressure to make sure that really we secure and protect teaching time, but at the same time, making sure that we protect the lives of our learners and our teachers.
You've also mentioned the issue, or rather challenges that you've been facing. We also know that you previously had assistant teachers, but now their contract has ended. They were complimenting the staff in terms of making sure that this process in terms of COVID-19, in schools. So what is it now that we have done to make sure that when you receive full capacity, you will have people that will assist in terms of regulations?
Well, indeed, that those teachers' assistants were very helpful. Most of the school were happy with their services. At the present moment, under this current condition, we have developed what we call the risk adjustment strategy, where we make sure that all COVID-19 protocol are religiously followed. So we'll make sure that in our school is adequate social distances, learners are wearing their masks appropriately, we sanitize, and as I've indicated, one of the things that we will want to do under this trying condition is to try to be creative enough and look at other options that we have in the interest of making sure that our learners receive education, which is key.
The issue of overcrowding, you've touched it a little bit, but now I want to understand, will you be having extra, maybe temporal structures to make sure that teaching and learning continues? Is this part of your plan, or how are you going to make sure?
These are part of our plan, where we're going to provide some mobile classrooms, in other situations, you'll have a school with a mobile classroom which they don't need. We'll then redirect those mobile classrooms to other schools. As the situation is a very delicate situation, it needs all of us as stakeholders, as trade unions, as SGPs, as parents, to think outside the box, to come with a solution, to make sure that we strike the balance between protecting the teaching time and making sure that we don't put our learners and our teachers at risk.
Where are you in terms of vaccinating teachers?
Our vaccination drive in the provinces went very well. I can confirm that more than 92% of our teachers and support staff has been vaccinated, and that gives us a comfort to say in that condition at least it mitigates and it lessens the risk of infection. And then that is why I was saying, if we accept learners and those learners making sure that they follow properly the COVID-19 protocol, which amongst other things is to make sure that they properly wear their mask, we think that will be helpful enough.
At some point, schools were super spreaders here in the Free State. How has been the situation now in terms of your numbers of people that are infected from school?
Well, it's difficult to say now because schools are still starting they're opening. But I can confirm that since the school opened, we have not had any incident that suggests that the schools are now outbreak. And I think we can attribute that to the vaccination drive that we had previously.
So come Tuesday, Free State is ready to receive full capacity of primary school learners?
We are ready, but that will also depend on the school. We have said the school where they feel or that they are able to accept all learners. Firstly, they must do the presentation or ask a permission from the HOD who will grant that permission. They will outline as to when will they be ready to accept to come into a full capacity and welcome all primary school learners.
Other schools that will be visited by the minister?
The minister from this school where we are, which is Butleha, the primary school, will be visiting two special schools, which is Pulu and Zwelang, and then from there he'll be visiting a UNICEF primary school. That will be the end of the minister's itinerary today.
Howard Ndaba, education spokesperson here in the Free State, saying that of course they're waiting for the minister to arrive. However, as the province is saying that there's some schools that are ready to receive full capacity of learners from Tuesday. However, where there are challenges, he says that schools will have to be engaging with them so that they can find a solution, as he does mention that already with this academic year they have delayed, but also the issue of teachers that have been vaccinated, saying it is a positive step, as he mentions that it's more than 92% of teachers and supporting staff people that have been vaccinated in schools here in the province. From here, minister will go to special schools and also UNICE primary school just to check the state of readiness. But we see here already people are ready. There's a COVID-19, you know, compliance, and as we see here, they also taking some temperature and also sanitizing. We're still waiting for the minister, and we will be following her out right through just to understand her side of Free State, knowing that it's been a super spreader at some point when it comes to schools. But Howard saying that for now there hasn't been any reports since the reopening of the school. There hasn't been any reports of confirmed COVID-19 cases. However, with most teachers being vaccinated, the situation is expected to get better.
Apumilele, thank you so much for that update.